Hello, welcome to Flip SG. So now we are on the topic of isomerism, okay, and how to identify isomers. So really, isomers are just compounds with the same molecular formula, but different structural formula. So because the key phrase, the key word here in the learning objective is defined, so you really have to memorize this whole sentence here, okay? And it'll be worth 1 mark. Okay, let's delve right into it, okay? So really, what is molecular formula and what is structural formula? Okay, let me just give you an example. Remember our C4H10. Then you remember what is it? Okay, this is actually butane. Okay, and in our previous video, we taught you to draw butane, right? Remember, based on number of C's, you just link them up. Okay, and the remaining space, okay, you just fill them with hydrogens, correct? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 hydrogens, 4 carbons. Okay, so this is butane. What if I draw it like this? Okay, C, C, I go down, C, go up, C, I fill the rest with hydrogen. Remember, there have to be 4 bonds around carbon, right? Okay, so how many carbons are there now? 1, 2, 3, 4. How many hydrogens? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So this is also C4H10. This is also C4H10. So what's going on here? Okay, because butane is able to be in this form and this form, this is called structural differences. Okay, it can be in a linear form, it can be a bit branched. Okay, branched because like a branch, it branches out. Correct, like a tree branch, it branches out. So it's called branch, okay? Whereas this is linear because it's straight, right? Okay, so this is the difference. So there you have it. This is isomerism because they are the same compound, okay? They have the same name, butane, C4H10. This is the name, which is called molecular formula. But they look different in that they have different structural formula, okay? This applies for all homologous series and not just alkanes. Okay, so you may be confused because this is quite confusing already, right? Imagine if I give you this. Okay, this is actually pentane, C5H12. You don't have to know this, but it's good to know because it may come out in an exam, but you won't be required to name this. Okay, you're just required to know from methane to butane. Okay, but pentane may come out as a question which specifically asks you to identify isomers. Okay, let me give you 3 examples. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Correct? These are all hydrogens. Just imagine that. Okay, this is 1. Okay, let me scroll down a little. Second one. This is also pentane. Okay, 5 carbon. The rest are H's. Okay. Finally, I have this. C, but it comes down here. Okay. The rest are hydrogens. Okay. Just a recap. All in alkanes. Okay. Alkanes. The C's have to be surrounded by 4 bonds. Okay. And those bonds are hydrogen. Okay. I left them out because, just to save time. But you should obviously draw them. Okay, so what's the difference between them? They are all C5H12, correct? How do we identify that they are isomers? They are isomers because they have the same name, same molecular formula. Okay, so this is checked already. Okay, but do they have the different structural formula? Yes. Okay, let me show you why. Different structural formula also. How do we identify? I give you a tip. Actually, you just have to look for the longest C chain. For example, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so this is one of them. It's 5 straight carbons. What about this? 1, 2, 3. If I go up this way, this is also 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. This is only 3 straight carbons, correct? So if I draw it like that, I think it'll be clearer. And this is only 3. Am I right? Because if you go anyway, either way, it's only gonna give you 3 carbons with the longest chain. Am I right? If you go this way, 3. If you go up here and turn here, this is also 3. Go up here and turn here, it's also 3. What about here? Okay, the longest carbon will actually give me 1, 2, 3, 4. If I go this way, also 4. So there are only 2 ways to go about it. And both ways will give me 4 carbon as the longest chain. Do you agree? Okay, so there you have it. This is a straight chain of 5 carbons. This is a straight chain. This is a branch chain with the longest of 3 carbon. This is also a branch chain with the longest of 4 carbon. And that's why they are different structural formula. Okay, and hence they are isomers. Okay, so you may, we'll, in future videos, we'll discuss further examples of how to identify them. But basically, just a recap, you have to look for the longest carbon chain that you can find. Okay, and that's all for isomers.